My name is Brad Sarsfield. I'm a developer on the Hadoop for Windows and Windows Azure team. Today I'm going to show you two different ways to upload data into a Hadoop cluster on Windows Azure. Once the data is uploaded to my cluster, I'll use one of the samples, which are included with Hadoop on Windows Azure, to run a WordCount MapReduce job against the new data I've uploaded into my cluster. To upload the data, I have many options. I can use the Interactive JavaScript Console, Secure FTPS, Azure Blob Store, Amazon S3, or import data from the Azure Data Mart. Let's start with the JavaScript Interactive Console. The first thing I need to do is to create a directory for my data in HDFS inside my cluster. I name the directory example data. To select a file on my local hard drive, I use fs.put. The name of the local file I'm uploading is davinci.txt, and the HDFS destination is my newly created example data folder. Click Upload. That's it. To make sure the file is properly uploaded, I run the /ls command to see the directory listing of the file. Another way I'm going to show you how to upload data into HDFS on Windows Azure is via Secure FTP. The FTP server runs on the head node inside Windows Azure. We chose Secure FTP because regular FTP puts your credentials clear text over the wire. Another security requirement for the FTPS service is that the password must be MD5 hashed. By default, Hadoop on Windows Azure FTPS port is closed. To open the port, select the Opens Port tile. Toggle the FTPS port. In the background, this opens up the port on my Hadoop cluster's head node and allows me to upload a file via FTPS now from the internet. The FTPS client that we recommend is called Curl, and we make it easy for you to use Curl and MD5 hash your password by including a PowerShell sample script. The sample script is included here with the WordCount sample. To use the script, I download it to my local box and fill in the appropriate cluster name, my username, and password. Now, when I open up PowerShell and call the script, it uploads the specified davinci.txt file to the examples data directory in HDFS. And there you have the second way to upload data to your Hadoop cluster on Windows Azure. Now it's time to deploy the WordCount job. Hadoop on Azure comes with samples I can use for learning and testing. Today I'm going to use the WordCount Java MapReduce sample to count the occurrences of each word in the davinci.txt file that we just uploaded. I'm going to run this example on my cluster using the Hadoop examples jar. The job template is pre-populated with the appropriate job name. It attaches the jar file and sets all of the parameters that need to be passed in to make the job run successfully. It even displays the final command that will be run on the head node. So for my job, the parameters are the word count to indicate that we're running the word count examples for the Hadoop examples jar, and then the input, davinci.txt, and the output, davinci all top words. The final command that will be executed is constructed below. I click on execute job. Each map process reads a line from the file and then parses all of the words. The output of the map is a key value pair for each word and the number one. The reducers then sum up the counts for each of the words from all of the map outputs and in turn output each word and its total occurrences for the final output. The job page displays the status. The standard errors section contains the messages from Hadoop, things like status, statistics, and informational messages on the progress throughout the lifecycle of the job. The output section contains messages generated by the WordCount Java code. My job completed successfully. I see that a new file called DaVinci All Top Words has been created. I can switch now to the JavaScript console and view that data by doing an fs read. This is an fs.read, and I'm specifying DaVinci All Top Words file. What's going to be outputted is the complete file of all of the words that are in the davinci.txt, and we can see that the word and its frequency. I used two different methods to upload data to Hadoop on Windows Azure, and then ran the WordCount example Java MapReduce program on that data. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this example helpful.